It is true that a lack of funding and needed skills and also poor attitude are mitigating against the progress of democracy in Africa. However, even more significantly, crony capitalism may well be a primary culprit undermining the dividends of democracy in Africa. In many countries, political alienation has created a stranglehold on competition and has led to the impoverishment and bleeding of large proportions of the population. Democracy should not, indeed never, be shy of focusing on poverty reduction. It is the political courage and will to fight and root out poverty that creates the conditions for wealth creation and economic growth, not the other way around. The World Economic Forum for Africa has just highlighted the importance of inclusive growth for a faster pace of economic growth and development in Africa. Let it be well noted, crony capitalism, which has largely made Africa's brand of democracy unrecognizable, contributes strongly to income inequality. There is too much cost that society bears and suffers when only party loyalists and cronies win contracts and get key jobs. When this happens, it is likely that competition is trampled, with regulations and the rule of law thrown out the window. Without the rule of law, impunity takes over society in every manner and leads to a survival of the fittest syndrome. The rich get richer and the poor get poorer. Economic growth and development are gravely undermined when poverty is not addressed. Poor governance is often seen in democracy driven by crony capitalism, and it leads to income inequality and uncompetitiveness. Generally, if we want performance-driven democracy, political inflation must end. As I have defined it, political inflation occurs when a set of politicians fill and congest the political space without producing commensurate dividends of democracy. Bottom line, performance-driven democracy can assure inclusive growth, reverse income inequality, and speed economic development. I'm Magnus Pakol, and that's my view.